Welcome to this video on how to create a view in SharePoint 2013. In this video, we'll demonstrate views, create a view interactively, and begin to explore the various settings for views. A view controls the way content in a list or library is displayed. Let's take a look at a standard document library that contains a dozen or so files. Views appear at the top of the library. For document libraries, the first view on the left is All Documents, which is the view that appears whenever a user initially sees the library. This particular library has several customized views as well. The Author view groups the documents by name of author. To expand the group, just click the author's name. The Document Type view is grouped by type of file. Up to three views appear at the top of the library. Any additional views are in the drop-down that appears when you click this ellipsis. Here's a fourth view of files grouped by milestone, and a fifth view of files grouped by status. Now, if we look at an asset library, you'll see that the default view is a visual display of thumbnails. As you hover over each thumbnail in this example, you'll see that the library contains a video and an image. The All Assets view is also created for all asset libraries and shows more details for each file in the library. Lists use views in the same way as libraries, so let's quickly review two typical lists. A contacts list uses all contacts as the default view. This list also has a few other customized views. By department groups contacts by their department. Support only shows only the contacts who work within the support department, and Web Services Only displays just the staff of the Web Services department. Our second list example is a calendar. The default calendar view is a standard wall calendar display. Note that views do not appear at the top of the calendar in the default view. To get to the views, go to the ribbon. Under the Calendar tab, you'll see an area called Current View. The drop-down lists the available views for the calendar. All calendars have two views created in addition to the default calendar view. All Events is a list of every event in the calendar in a standard SharePoint list view. The views do appear at the top of the list. Finally, Current Events is a list of upcoming events. The views do not appear at the top of the list, but are again available through the ribbon. The simplest way to create a view is to interactively modify an existing view, then save it as a new view. Here's a list that contains daily reports submitted by field inspectors. The default view of all items is sorted in ascending order of status, then ascending order of last name. We want to create a view that displays only the reports for sunny days, sorted by high temperature. First, let's use a filter to select only the reports submitted on sunny days. Hover over the weather column, click the down arrow, and click sunny. Close the dialog. Now let's arrange the reports in ascending order of high temperature. Hover over the high temperature column, click the down arrow, and click smallest on top. Now that the list has been modified, click Save This View. Enter a name for the new view. Be sure to use a meaningful name so others can easily understand what is included in this view. We'll use High Temps on Sunny Days. And we'll make it public so everyone can see it. Click Save. And here's your new view. It contains only days where the weather was sunny and is sorted in order of high temperature. Let's create another view of the daily reports list. This time, we will use the Create View command and explore the most commonly used view settings. In our new view, we want to display only the daily reports from the Triad Economic Development region. We want those reports grouped by status and sorted by last name. Finally, we do not want to see all the columns we've used before, just a few of them. Click the List tab and Create View. You can also click the ellipsis by the list of views and click Create View. First, let's define the view type. You haven't seen this choice before because in our previous example we modified an existing view. Here the difference is that we are creating a new view. There are several view types. Choose carefully because the view type cannot be changed once a view is created. The standard view displays items or files in rows. A standard view is usually the default view, and it's the view that the daily reports is in by default. The calendar view is automatically created for calendars, but is available for any list or library that has a date-time column. We've already seen an example of that earlier in this video. The Access view lets you use Microsoft Access to interact with SharePoint. Skip this option unless you have Access installed on your computer and you've gotten permission from web services to use Access with SharePoint. The Datasheet view is the same as Quick Edit and is an efficient way to make multiple edits at a time. Here's our daily reports list in a Datasheet view. The Gantt view is used by project managers to track progress and tasks. Here's a screenshot of a Gantt view that was used on another project. Finally, you can use an existing view as a starting point for a new view. This is useful if you need several similar views, such as the same contact information for different divisions or districts. Explanations over. Let's choose the standard view. We'll call the view Triad EDR. We do not want this to be the default view, so we will skip that option. In the Audience section, be sure Create a Public View is chosen so everyone can see and use the view. Choose carefully, because you cannot change the audience once a view is created. We only want 5 columns to appear in the view: title, status, last name, county, and division. So, in the Columns section, we'll uncheck the columns for contract number, date, high temperature, and weather. And let's swap the order of division in county. Using the drop-down, change the order for county from 8 to 10 to place it after division. When the view is saved, SharePoint takes care of renumbering automatically. Since we want to sort by last name in ascending order, let's go to the Sort section. Under First Sort by the Column, select Last Name, and be sure Show Items in Ascending Order is selected. We also want to filter for only the 12 counties that are in the Triad Economic Development Region. In the Filter section, click Show Items Only When the Following is True to set up the logic. We want the county to equal Alamance, or the county to equal Caswell. But we also want to include the remaining 10 counties in the logic. So, for each of the next 10 counties, click Show More Columns and add the logic for each county. Here we'll do Davidson County, and you'll need to repeat this for Davie, Forsyth, Guilford, Montgomery, Randolph, Rockingham, Stokes, Surrey, and Yadkin counties. Finally, we want to group the view by status of the report. So expand the Group By section, select Status from the First Group By the Column drop-down, and ensure Show Groups in Ascending Order is selected. We want to show the groups in a collapsed state by default, and we'll stick with a limit of 30 groups per page. Click OK, and you'll see the new view that took us just a couple of minutes to create. Simply click the link to expand each group. One caveat: if you want to use this Group By option, you cannot use the Datasheet view type. In this video, we've examined how to work with and create views in SharePoint 2013. There's a companion video that describes the more advanced view settings and the interaction of views, columns, and web parts, so take a look at it once you're comfortable with this material. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main Help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint Help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log into Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC Training Group. Thanks for watching.